My name is Nathorn, CEO of ISO Training Center. I'm doing the ERP for the ISO compliance. It's the first time for me to raising fund. Yeah.
So you're looking for equity type of crowdfunding.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes. So should we start now?
Hopefully.
Okay.
No, the slide is not on. I have backup plan, okay? You want it? Yeah. So let me introduce myself. So hopefully this not count in 3 minutes. I'm the CEO of ISO Training Center. I'm do the ISO database. That's working on cloud. It's quite new for the Asian country. And today I want to like to show the everyone about our software and our business model. Because I already have a customer in Thailand and also in Laos PDR and also in Cambodia. And I would like to scale the software to other country, and I focus on in Asia. So the ISO Basecamp is like we make your business success. ISO is international standard. It's not nice to have, it's must have. And our competency is about people. I have worked as an auditor for 14 years. I have been audit more than 1,000 factories in Thailand. And I have developed a software last year and got the winning for the Smart Expo. And also I have a good team. I have a PhD. Actually, it's my high school friend, had graduated in computer science in the US, and I have full-time advisor right now working at Cisco United States. So our competency is about people. This is a software feature. Mainly, the software is focused on in the factory, because factory have to have the ISO to sell the products. And the software that we have now connect to the hardware, which is a machine. It's an Internet of Things concept, and connect with the machine. We can monitor the machine online and so on. And this is the machine that we monitor online. When the machine is on, off, idle, set up, and so on. And we can monitor like many things from the machine. ISO certificate still going up in Asia, especially Thailand, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam, and so on. I think it's a good time to have a software to manage, because if you implement the ISO, you know it's very painful. A lot of paper, a lot of requirement, and so on. So this our team. Already explained to you that we have three auditor business background. I have an advisor in Japanese, because in Thailand 30% is a Japanese factory. Okay, and this gentleman is my cousin now working at Cisco in the United States. This is our business model. We have a model to sell to the factory, like a global factory, in 20,000 US per license, and we also sell on cloud. On cloud for the factory, we sell for 150 US per month, which is a lot cheaper if compared to the competitors. And as the auditor, I design the software myself, so I know that which is good for customer and easy to use and so on. This is a customer in Thailand. We are here to raising fund to scaling business in Asia. Or 1.5 million company worldwide have to do the ISO, and this is for Asia. Thank you.
Thank you.
So who do you see, who are your main competitors?
Main competitor in Thailand, only one company. And the company that can I cannot like spell the name of the competitor, but the company that do the software like me, they do only on the notebook or desktop, and my software is like a responsive design, can control, can work on the mobile.
What about outside Thailand? Who are your competitors?
Competitor about 5% of total market that use a competitor. For me, I 0.3% of the overall market in Thailand. In Thailand, 8,500 company certified.
Why do you choose crowdfunding as a method for fundraising? Because I would have thought this is a enterprise B2B software. What makes you think it would have public appeal on the platform?
For me, I like reduce the business risks. Actually, right now my customer also have like a B2B, like an enterprise or corporate solution, and I think the more market is for like a medium and small company, and I think $150 per month is effective or the good money, because for the small company they have to hire people to do the document control and so on for the ISO. My software just like replace the cut cost for the operator or the people to take care of the system.
My question is, why do you choose crowdfunding versus other type of investment?
It's very new. It's a new in Thailand, very new crowdfunding, and also my software also very very new also that can work on mobile. So I tried. I don't know other way to work. Actually, in my company, the software already break even. I already earn money, passive income already have. But I think the opportunity that to grow outside the Thailand, maybe a lot that can do. But crowdfunding just only choice that I pick up.
How many percentage that you will exchange for the fund you raise?
20% of share equity of my company.
And what do you want your company the fund you raise to do for?
I have already put it. Could you show the slide? Yeah, I would like to set office for overseas office, especially in Asia, for example, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Vietnam, and I would like to find a certified partner, because to implement the program, we need a certified partner to understand about product and help me for implementing. And also, I need to develop project more about smart factory. These are develop the hardware prototype to do like a connect machine to the mobile phone, and also advertising and brand. So these are about it. Thank you. Thank you very much.